Good morning, everybody. You know, dove season is right around the corner, and there's nobody I'd rather talk to about honey, period, than Nelson Wingo here at Campbell's Hardware. And Nelson, let's go over everything that people can do to be more comfortable, more accurate, and be a better dove hunter.
Okay. This is one of our newer stools. We actually started selling them last year. It's just a three-legged stool. It's got a small seat on it, kind of like a bicycle seat, but it's very comfortable. This is probably the old standby. It's been around forever. It's just basically a 5-gallon plastic bucket. You can buy them with the pouches on them like we have them, or we have them that are just spray painted camo.
But this one particular item right here, it really has helped a lot, hasn't it?
It will attract birds. But you can blend the one or two mojos, and then get you a few of the lesser expensive ones, just the decoys, and right. You can set them around on it. They make two different ways. This particular one comes with a magnetic wing.
Yeah, you know what? I noticed I really like that. You know, instead of having that thing twisted and whatever.
You had to set an Allen screw and go through that. With these, they just snap on and are magnetized and stay on there. And then once you put them in there, you turn them on, and you can get about 6 to 8 hours. A full running time out of a set of batteries. It takes 4 AA batteries. But working together just gives it a better spread. It's like in the days of the duck decoys. It just looks better to have a few ducks out there, same way with doves.
A blind really is important, right?
It is, because as you shoot birds, and a lot of people shoot in the same fields over and over, as you shoot, these birds do get leery of hunters. So the more you can conceal yourself, whether it be camouflage clothes or ground blinds, getting closer to the ground or getting close to corn stalks or tree. This helps in just breaking your image. So later on in the year, as the birds come down, especially the northern birds, when they come in, they've been shot from the time they left Tennessee.
Top of the state.
Coming on down. So, you know, they're pretty gun shy. So it's real good to have these. And like I said, we sell a lot of them. We've got the local company.
What kind of blind is this now?
This is a nylon. It's got made out of nylon mesh. They're basically 16 feet long. They stand up 48 to 50 inches tall.
Okay.
So working them in sunflower fields or corn fields or even brown top millet. And that's the reason we carry them in this color. They're more of a dried look.
What do we need to think about when we're shooting shells?
Well, there's a lot of different varieties of shells. The theory behind shells now is not so much the ounce of shot or the dram equivalent of powder, it's the speed of the shot. So many dove loads now are actually on the box, will not say 3 1/4, 1 1/8, which is a standard 12 gauge dove load like these Remingtons. It will say this shot is 1200 feet per second or 1175 feet per second. And that's what people are beginning to equate good shooting to. Now the first part of the year, normally all that's needed is your standard dove load. The 3 1/4, 1 1/8 is an excellent load. As year progresses and the northern birds come in or the birds get more flighted, then people sometime will move up to a higher velocity shell, some of them known as high brass shells. And they're priced down to a point that, you know, you can get these shells now during the sale and stuff for around $65 for a 10-box case. You cannot even reload for that anymore due to the price of shot and powder and other parts of the reloading process. So people now are just buying the factory-made stuff. And they're excellent shells, and like I said, the regular field loads run into $65 to $70 for a 10-box case, where the high brass will run from $87 to $100, depending on what brand.
These two are 20-gauge.
Right.
And, you know, tell me what you like about that.
Well, the 20-gauges are normally lighter on recoil. They're lighter guns overall. For women and children and even me, I've always shot a 20-gauge gun.
I know you have.
Shot stream on a 20-gauge is excellent for bird hunting. And like I said, they're just a good all-around gun. Now, if you're shooting in open field where you need to shoot in long-range shots, or if you're pheasant hunting or duck hunting, yes, a 12-gauge is a gun of choice. But for dove hunting where you have a bag limit like we do, 12, 15 birds, depending on where you're hunting.
Right.
You know, we're selling more 20s and 28 gauge now than we are the 12s. We still sell quite a few 16s when we can get them.
Right.
A lot of people do like a 16 gauge gun, and we carry a full line of 16 gauge ammo for them. But more people for the bird, upland game birds, quail hunting, quail preserves, dove hunting, the 20 gauge is actually taking over the market.
So this is a Browning, you said silver.
Silver hunting. Okay. That has taken the place. This is one Browning's auto loader. People now are liking to see the silver nitride, and this is non-reflective, so the doves will not shy away from it. The stocks are now oil rub finish.
That's nice.
It is real nice. It doesn't have a lot of shine. And this stock, if you scratch it or ding it, we can take it out and we can fix it for you. So more and more people are getting away for the real high shiny guns, because a high polished gun, sun will reflect off of
right.
it, so the birds will see it. This happens to be the M2 Benelli. It's fully camo. It's got the Comfortec stock. Yeah. This design is a limb saver design. It's got a butt pad here, and it's got limb saver style material embedded in the stock.
Right.
This in itself, as is the cheek piece, all these work together to help absorb some of the recoil.
Nelson, thanks a bunch. I always learn a lot. You know, you can learn a lot coming out here, and this weekend, come out to Campbell's Hardware and Sporting Goods in Robertsdale. They're going to have the hunting pros out here for dove season. Get your hip stamp and your hunting license for this year and learn a lot. I'm Gary Finch for 3 in the Morning.